everybody, it's Fran in the lab again. Fran Lab, how are you doing? Okay, well, it's getting kind of chilly in the lab, so I'm layered up, and I've got this little gizmo on the bench today. Something that I really like a lot. It's this Star Trek comm panel, which came to me from a viewer. It was in viewer mail number 9, and I really like this a lot. And I want to put it on the wall of the lab, but it's not quite exactly really the way that I want it to be, because anyone who is a fan of the original Star Trek, you recognize this panel. It's sort of a version of the panels that were in the original Star Trek episodes. This one's smaller than the actual props, but it incorporates some of the things, the comm panel, and the round snappy button, although this button is not snappy. It's got the right size and shape. the little white thing that I believe this used to be the red alert thing, although in this version it doesn't light up, which I really want it to. That's one thing I want to change. The other thing is it's got these motion detectors, you know, on the sides, and you can select on the back which side you want to be sensitive to trigger the sounds. One left side or right side or both. I guess the idea is mounted on the wall next to a door, and when you come through the door, oh, the red alert. Okay, so in the down position, it'll do the red alert. Okay. Oh, geez. Okay. This is what I don't like about it. This is why I want to change it, because I want to be able. I want to be able to select that sound without having it be like firing off every time something moves around in the lab, or whenever. I don't like motion detectors for stuff like this. It's just it's fine for a kid's toy, but as an adult, it would drive me crazy for it always be going off. So I want to use the sounds, but I don't want to use the motion detectors. And I want it to be more like the original panel. I want this thing in the middle to actually turn red instead of this blinky thing. And it looks like it would be a button, you know, like you press that, but it's not a button. It's just a lens with an LED behind it. And so that's the red alert. The other one was the motion sensor swish. Yeah, okay, that's the door swish. So what I want to do is modify this, if I can, to sort of make it so that I can use it as a red alert siren, but without using the motion sensors. I want to put a button here to hit it for red alert and have this shine up, you know, being flash as the red alert, and keep this as the whistle. Right, and then I think if I can do that, I can put it on the wall and then use it in, you know, lab stuff. You know, if something goes wrong, I can hit the red alert and we'll get a chuckle on that. But let's take a look on the inside, see what we're up against altering this Star Trek toy to be just what I want it to be. Well, here's the panel. It's very hard to show something like this that's just basically completely shiny with all the lights and everything. yeah, this was sent in by Jeff Broido, I believe. Like I said, it's in viewer mail number 9. I've already taken the screws out just to save time. Alright. Well, there's not much in here, like you would think. Pretty much one little tiny circuit board. I think this is the switch for the front there. Just the switch. This is also just a switch, a little button there, and that's the panel light, the blinky thing where I want to put the switch in. And yeah, and this too, this there's nothing behind here. See, it's just the battery compartment. But I think, you know, in the original series, I think that's actually what turned red, had like a red light in it. There's a LED here. I want to move that over there and probably put two LEDs and maybe a piece of paper or something behind it, just to like to act as a reflector, just to kind of get the light to shine on that and get that to light up red. And I want to put a switch in here and hook it up to the sensor, basically remove the sensor. So this is a pretty typical PIR type sensor, passive infrared sensor detector. You find them in all kinds of things these days, I guess, and I guess they're pretty handy to detect anything that's got like a heat signature, like a finger or a person. But yeah, I don't really like them for this kind of application. It should be very easy to just bypass this and put in a regular switch up here to basically do what this does and trigger the sound effect. Take a look under the board here. Oh, speaker's just flopping around. Looks like that's just held in place by a post. It's just pushing on the speaker, holding it in place. It's not really hooked up to anything. All right, there you go. Not much to see. Gotta get my loop out for this. But it's a TM2291. All right, so I found out that's a Titan Micro TM2291. So that's the driver chip or controlling chip for the motion sensor. So that's controlling the triggering just for the motion stuff. So all of the sounds and everything must be underneath this goopified potted chip on board. So all the sound effects and stuff are right there. Yeah, I'm pretty optimistic. I should be able to hack this because it's pretty much all it is. And maybe looks like a couple transistors, probably an audio amplifier just for the output. I'm pretty optimistic about being able to hack this though, because these infrared sensors tend to be pretty simple. These kinds of detectors are pretty simple. They've got three legs. One side usually goes to the ground, and the other side is going to go to some sort of V+, either, you know, directly to the rail or maybe through a diode or something, but it's to the positive supply. And then when motion is detected, the signal on the output leg goes high. You could hook it up to, you know, just a standard NPN transistor. And you could have hook it up to a relay, and it's pretty simple. You know, just you could either directly drive a relay with a transistor switch, or use the output to trigger a timer circuit, something like that. But this is a very oversimplified kind of schematic. But this is basically how it works. So. Taking into consideration that signal is going to be going to that TM2291 chip, I should be able to just trigger it by taking this output from the sensor, or take that wire and just, you know, tap it to the V+. Should trigger the whole thing. It should be pretty easy to find out too. Okay, so. Just using the multimeter, I've determined that the gray wire is the negative rail, so I should be able to trip the sound effect just by shorting out the other two lines. I've stripped a little bit of insulation off one of the wires. And so clamp onto that, and I should be able to, let's see if I got the, is it on? Yeah, okay, it's on. Do I have it to, okay. What I want to do it for, okay, the first thing I got to do is tape over the sensor so that it doesn't trip from my messing around with it. All right, tape over that. That way I don't trigger it by accident. I got the switch over to the left. Okay, and I'm going to put it on red alert. Okay, and I should be able to just short it out right against here. Ah, yep. No worries. All right. All right, so that's going to work, no problem. All I got to do is mount in a switch in here, and the big problem I see is that the panel is very thin, so there's not a whole lot of space in there. There's just way too little room in here to mount like a standard. Something like this would be pretty typical half-inch panel switch. You know, all the switches I have in stock, push buttons, are gonna have something to this kind of depth to them, and there's just no way that you could put that in there. But looking at this bezel, it looks like I can modify this existing thing. I think I can take this little bezel and actually make it into a switch and replace this board with another board, just like a perf board, that I can mount another switch on, a shallow one, like these little micro PCB mount switches. I got a bunch of these for my Sputnik project, and I've got even got some caps I can scrounge. I can snap on there to extend it a little bit, and this switch I can mount on a little piece of perf board and put it in there to replace this board and convert this lens into basically a cap for that switch, and then move the LEDs over here to eliminate that, and it's pretty much going to get me what I want, I think. All right, so this is looking good. So let's take off this board and see what we're looking at here. All right, yeah, this will totally work. Okay, yeah, I can totally modify that. It's a lot deeper than I thought it was. For some reason, I thought it was a lot shallower than that. Yeah, I mean, I can utilize the existing parts, use these as spacers, just as they are before. That'll go in there like that. And I got a cap, I can glue that in there, extend that, and that'll become a switch. All I gotta do is cut these spacers from the centerpiece, and that'll become a button. And yeah, it's totally doable. Yep. All right, I got these little add-on caps. Again, this is from my Sputnik project. Snap on like that. That should give me enough room. Let's see here. If I can glue that in the bottom there. Oh, geez, that's that is perfect. I couldn't have planned that. Look at that. It's exactly the right depth. Ah, all right. So I don't have to like put any goop or anything, just probably a little drop of super glue in there, cyanoacrylate glue, and be set. All I gotta do is detach this from the spacers and grab a piece of perf board to chop down. One cap, it is free. Just trimming off the excess from the spacers. Use those as two spacers. Okay. looking for the polarity here, and you can always look for the characteristic anode in an LED, which shows that the should be the plus side. We all be able to put it together again on the other side. And two, I'm going to use this board as a template to be able to make a new board, and it'll have the holes centered correctly so I can just drop it right in the spot. Alright, so you should just be able to drop this in the hole. That's actually a tight fit. Not gonna make this easy. I'm gonna have to file that out a little bit. Perfect. Just needed a touch. That right in the middle. Oh yeah, that's gonna work. Okay. Which side is the normally open? Normally closed. I guess the normally closed. So the other side is the normally open. All right, let's test this out. Put the battery in. To the left, turn on the switch, and let's see here. All right, success. All right, I knew it would work. Was there ever any doubt? All right, so all I gotta do is put a good drop of cyanoacrylate glue on that button and quickly screw it into place. And that'll take care of both the alignment and the mounting all in one shot. So, right. It's gonna all happen really fast. So. Contact. Applying a little pressure just to get the contact just right. Let that set up. Thank you.
Okay.
Go berserk. In my lab, that's where I work.
See if this works. Oh, broke a wire. It's bound to happen sooner or later. Broke the ground wire. Okay. Man, look how thin that wire is. That is super thin. Barely any wire there. Down. Okay, down, left. Okay, here we go. Ah! Red alert! Alright, well, it works. Oh, what happened there? Oh, just got flashed there. Oh, I'd say it flashes intermittently because it's in the red alert mode. So I'm gonna glue this card behind this. Hopefully I can get it to, I'm gonna take the battery out. Hopefully I can get it to reflect a little bit. You know, I was thinking, oof, slide it under there. Kind of glue it kind of parabolic-like. Do we even have room to do that? Something like that. Oh man, my tremor's really going gangbusters today. I think we're done. I think this is it. All right. Gonna close it up. Looks like this, the battery compartment. Of course. Battery compartments go well. Oh, jeez. Well, my best laid plans of making this sort of nice and is it gonna go together? It's just gonna have to go together and squish. Oh well. I tried to make it parabolic, but it just doesn't want to go that way. Here we go. Final commitment, putting the back on. All right. Let's see, here we go. Okay, I can do the whistle. All right, whistle. And. Ah! What's it? The LEDs aren't going on. So, I must have broken something. What did I break? Broke something. Oh, when I push this together, the positive terminal from the battery came up and shorted the LED. Man. Okay, so, all right, a little tweaking. So sticky. Ugh. All right. Jeez. It's always something. All right. Set it off accidentally, but it's working. Okay. Okay. There you go. That was a constructive two and a half hours or something like that I spent. It'll be condensed down for the version you're going to see, but I spent a lot of time scrounging for some high-efficiency LEDs because the driver for this for the indicator, it's a very low current. So Frank, you should have hacked the board and found the LED. Yeah, okay, fine, yeah, but you know, it really wasn't well marked, and there were a lot of surface mounts. I wasn't going to spend 3 hours just changing out a resistor, so I just found some high efficiency LEDs, and so now I've got my whistle and red alert. All right, that works there. Yeah. All right, it works, red alert. I'd like a better display, but you know, you gotta work with what you got. I wasn't gonna spend like another hour or two building a driver in there to switch and drive like 6 bright LEDs and make it like a real display. I mean, that's really what it would have taken to get it like really bright enough, but hey, we got it. The lab has a red alert, so all right, it's now the way that I want it to be. Yeah, worked out pretty well making a switch out of something that wasn't ever intended to be a switch, making a lens cover into a switch, but all works. So all right, thanks for watching. Thanks too to all of the patrons over there on the Patreon thing, making all of these videos possible. I wouldn't be able to do this dumb stuff if it weren't for the people on Patreon. It's really the only reason that I'm able to do this. So if you like this stupid stuff, if you like the dumb things I do, then, you know, consider becoming a patron. It's easy to do. Just follow the link in the description. Become a patron. Okay. That's it. I'm Fran. I'll see you around the lab with something other stupid thing I'm gonna do, who knows what. But this will be on the wall next time. Yeah. See you back here real soon. Bye! Berserk in my lab, it's where I work. Watching. Friend love, it's what I'm doing. Working at the bench again.